andava a 100 all'ora per trovare la mia famiglia. Yeah, 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 yeah. Andava a 100 all'ora per cantare la serenata. Blam, 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 blam.
Rome, called the Eternal City, conjures up visions of ancient monuments, good food, and Vespas. In films like Roman Holiday, where beautiful Audrey Hepburn is zipping through the cobblestone city, visitors believe they will create their own movie on arrival. In Eat, Pray, Love, Julia Roberts dreamily wanders the streets and sits down for a delicious meal outside. Even the Lizzie McGuire movie over-romanticized the city as it chronicles the titular character's graduation trip to Rome. All these films are American-made and create an unrealistic depiction of Rome. These three films and more have become ingrained in the American psyche of what a trip to Italy might look like. Personally, I wanted to rent a Vespa, but through research, I found that it would be a very dangerous idea. My Roman holiday dreams were crushed for good reason. Similar to my experience, as you start your visit to Rome, you may be surprised when what was portrayed on screen does not align with reality. Rome, while rich in history and culture, also contains a troublesome past. Instead of only looking at films that romanticize Rome and create a false reality, viewing films that examine the turbulent past can help describe its current present. Two Italian films that depict Rome during an unstable period would be Rome Open City and Bicycle Thieves. These movies, made and spoken in Italian, are part of the neo-realist film movement that pulls the viewer into the harsh realities of World War II, bringing dark history to the big screen. Rome Open City is set during Nazi occupation and chronicles resistance fighters' stories as they struggle to fight for freedom. The Bicycle Thief is about a family who is trying to recover after World War II left many poor and without jobs. The father finds a job, but his bicycle is stolen, which restricts his ability to work. Viewing these films before visiting the city would provide context and level expectations. For example, seeing St. Peter's Basilica is a classic tourist spot, yet Rome Open City leaves a different impression to a viewer. One of the main characters, a Catholic priest, gets executed by Nazis at the end. The shadow of St. Peter's in the background pierces your soul as the symbol of faith wanes. Additionally, while food is a key part of Italian culture because it allows for time to be spent with family and friends during a meal, not all meals are created equal. In The Bicycle Thief, after the father and son have been disappointed by their failure to find their stolen bike, the father takes his heartbroken son out to eat. That is something they can't really afford, but the gesture goes a long way, especially in Italian culture. This enforces how integral the eating experience is in Italy. These contrasting scenes between Eat, Pray, Love and Bicycle Thieves allowed me to see the depth of food culture in Rome. Food in Bicycle Thieves was a reassuring constant that drew the father and son into a normalcy that was lacking in their lives. Americans, on the other hand, may expect engaging in fine dining to create an atmosphere for their jet-setting lifestyles. The food they both eat is the same, but the context in what they eat them is very different on many levels. I came to understand and value that fact through watching various authentic Italian films. Additionally, if you get too caught up in the gorgeous architecture and delicious food of the city, you might get pickpocketed, which would definitely ruin your day. To safely explore the city and all that it contains, you must be alert. Being on my guard wasn't a state I thought I would be in as much as I was, but it was the smartest idea after multiple stealing incidents me and my roommates experienced. People taking trips to Rome want to create their own memories in this city woven in so many stories, but awareness of the history and current surroundings is key to creating a well-rounded visit. I knew that I wanted to strut down the cobblestone streets as soon as that plane landed, but I didn't realize I would be walking over layers of often tragic history, in between walls plastered with graffiti. This conflicting reality was jarring, but allowed me to better appreciate what hard work and luck Rome had to go through for me to be present, seeing the sights I did in the conditions they were in. And after acquainting oneself to Italy's most famous city, you can head south for 2 hours to visit Naples, a city with a thriving past and a precarious present. Naples used to be one of the largest and most successful European cities in the 16th century. However, during the unification of Italy in 1861, it was forgotten by its country's new capital, Rome. Unfortunately, that leads it to be in the state it is in today. Going into my first visit of the city, I didn't have an over-romanticized expectation as I did with Rome. That is especially because organized crime still exists in the area and contributes to corruption and violence. It almost creates a singular story that pigeonholes the city into a gritty, crime-ridden caricature. Almost opposite of Rome, I had low expectations of this city, as it is stereotyped to be dirty and dangerous. There aren't many American films that over-romanticize the city and sets an unachievable expectation, so I went in with Gomorrah as my reference point. Gomorrah is a film that depicts fictitious stories of people during a real-life feud. The Camorra of Naples is one of the top criminal networks of Italy and was in the Scampia feud between 2004 and 2005, when Camorra gangs were rivaling each other. Characters in this film included a middleman, a 13-year-old who wants to join a gang, a waste management worker, a hot couture tailor, and two wannabe gangsters. Most characters have a gun to their head during some point of the film, some even ending up dead. The Scampia neighborhood where Gomorrah takes place is a hotspot for drug dealing and violence and is only 6 miles away from the tourist center of Naples. The movie is filmed on site most of the time. As a poor region of the country, buildings are less maintained and give you a reality check at this tourist hotspot. Often, many people only visit Naples as a launching off point to visit Pompeii or the Amalfi Coast, but I believe that is a missed opportunity. Naples, with the right awareness and preparedness, is a unique city that begs to be explored deeper if you give it a chance. Gomorrah and its dramatic stories are an element of Naples, but the more minute Italian experiences that lead to a well-rounded, amazing visit to the city are ones that simply must be lived to be understood. Warmer smiles, a laid-back atmosphere, and a gorgeous shoreline with Mount Vesuvius in the background were just some elements that made Naples a great city to visit. I enjoyed Naples so much that I visited 3 separate times when I was abroad, ensuring I ate Neapolitan pizza every single time. Having low to no expectations allowed me to appreciate any experience that sparked joy and fulfilled me. I went in understanding its instability and left understanding its charms. I used film as a reference point to articulate the ways in which a place transcends its film representation. I'm glad that I didn't let film depictions of Naples stop me from enjoying the city as it exceeded my expectations. However, one place surprised me even more than Naples did. Landing in Sicily, I was alone. No one whom I asked wanted to visit this island because of the stereotypes similar to Naples. Notably, Sicily is the birthplace of the Mafia. Its influence is still present in Sicily today, which can be seen by brutalist buildings and a clash between historic structures and shoddy apartment complexes. Representations of the Mafia in Sicily cross cultures and time periods, as both Italian and American films have popular stories revolving around organized crime. The old Italian film, In the Name of the Law, is about the Mafia's reign on a small Sicilian town in the 1940s, which prove how organized crime has been present for decades. Additionally, the famous American-made Mafia film, The Godfather, was set in Sicily that reaffirmed the inexplicable relationship between the island and organized crime. While the Mafia is an element of the island's character and history, it isn't its only one. The island also has a dreamlike atmosphere, acting almost as an island getaway from the mainland. Since Sicily is a blend of Byzantine, Islamic, and Western influences, it makes you feel like you almost aren't in Italy. I didn't realize the unique and fantastical character Sicily had until I visited. Cinema Paradiso, an acclaimed Italian film by Giuseppe Tornatore, creates a Sicilian world that is from a dream and stands as a love letter to the art form. That is the Sicily that people should realize, in my opinion. This film is set after World War II in a small Sicilian town whose residents bond over movies. It follows a small boy who grows to love film but has forgotten his hometown. It idealizes the area, but hopefully it also inspires people to visit. I know it did that for me. Cinema Paradiso also has an underlying message of the aspirational identity of what Sicily can become. Additionally, it proved the power of cinema and the responsibility film holds when depicting a place. Since Cinema Paradiso is set in a fictional town, I visited Cefalù, an hour west of Palermo, to channel the same atmosphere since it was a quaint town. One thing that contributed to an incredible day trip from Palermo was hiking to the top of the Rocca to the Temple of Diana to get sweeping views of the Mediterranean and the city below. It was one of the top moments of my life. Perhaps it was the clear blue sky or the landscape that looked like Hawaii, but the place Cinema Paradiso depicted closely aligned to my own experience. However, I realized that my description of Sicily might be an over-dramatization, thus contributing to an unrealistic standard of Italy. Either way, recommendations to visit Sicily often fall on deaf ears. Films like In the Name of the Law and The Godfather are so intertwined to the island that they create a single narrative that is difficult to forget unless you get to create your own memories. Despite the constant film representations of the mafia in Sicily, it isn't its only story. Films like Cinema Paradiso allow for dreamers to flock to the island. You should too. Overall, Italy and film are linked. Especially as American, the movie representations of the various cities across Italy are almost classics and set up our expectations before one can even visit. While you can visit Italy without considering its rich history through film, you leave yourself deprived of some moments of inspiration that can enhance your trip. There can be crime and danger, but there also can be rich character and dreams. All these films can be simultaneously true of what Italy is. Films show a snapshot on how others have experienced a place. Instead of just tourist things, engaging with Italian experiences represented through film is a way to immerse yourself in the country and create your own story. Narrative creates place, and place creates narrative. You write your own Italian story because people, like yourself, choose to travel to experience that place for themselves. Beyond the aesthetics of Italy, destinations have rich history that deserve to be explored and culture to be experienced. You are living in your own movie. Make it amazing.